Cedric yesterday. Harut wouldn't look at Cedric. Tonight, during the stare down, Cedric wouldn't look at Harut.
Yep. Harut's ready. He's got his eyes ready.
Here we go. The welterweight championship of the world up for grabs. Harut Gregorian in the white gloves. Cedric Doumbé in the black.
The big question with Harut Gregorian was, could he go five rounds if he needed to? And in his first title defense against Aleem Nabiev, he showed that.
大家好，老师从业中医男科30余年，帮助了数千名海内外华人朋友通过中药调理重回男性雄风。如果你也存在房事时间短、勃起无力、硬度差、中途疲软、肾虚、前列腺炎等问题，现在就加中医老师微信574-993-200，纯中药，一人一方，治根治本，帮助你持续坚挺20至40分钟，补肾壮阳，延时助勃，彻底告别快男软男。记住微信574-993-200。
Staying right in front of Doumbé, trying to keep his back against the ropes.
We saw when Harut fought Mertel Grunhardt, one landed shot, no matter where it is on the head, can end the contest.
See, this is the Doumbé we saw against Nicky Holtzkin. A little bit more movement, switching stances. Attacking on angles now.
And we saw in the fight prior to this, these French judges seem to at least favor a French fighter when things are even.
You just see how slick Doumbé is with his movement.
Doumbé with the low kick. He's not stopped moving, has he, Joe?
No, and he has to keep moving. I know he talked about wanting to sit in the pocket and throw, but this is his best strategy. A good strategy for Gregorian would be to take the legs. Because you notice every time Harut punches, Doumbé moves his head back. The head might move, but the legs are stationary. That's why you got to hit the legs or the body against a fighter who moves their head a lot.
When Doumbé's on, his movement is nearly untouchable. Just ask Johan Kongolo, who basically put his hands up in the air as the fight was winding down. Like, what else can I do? I can't hit him. But Nicky Holtzkin, the same thing. Fight! 10 seconds to go. Fairly even round statistically.
Yeah, it's very close. Doumbé is really good fighting off and going backwards. And that's what makes this really tough to score. Looks like Gregorian's doing well.
Fight! Round two. We are scheduled for 5. We'll see the official scores here from our ringside judges. There's 5 of them, and all 5 give it to Doumbé. Judge, I don't want to question their integrity, but this is exactly what we saw in our last fight. If the round is very close, they'll give it to the French fighter.
Yeah, and that's where Gregorian really needs to put forth a little bit more output.
Fight!
He can't just be chasing and following and using his ring control. He's got to put some offense.
And yes, it is close. You can see there. Similar landed strikes, but it was Gregorian who threw 11 more. And low kick. Great. Fight. Oh, nice left hand there from Doumbé. Then a low kick is run. Harut may be off balance, or he could be hurt.
I think, he's fired right back. Now we got a firefight.
Is that a knockdown? No, says Paul Nichols. Right back on the fire. Goes Doumbé.
Oh, he's a right hand.
Has just put the champ down.
1, 2,
Harut is dazed.
4, 5.
Doumbé beating him at his own medicine right now.
7.
We question his ability to sit in the pocket. And yes, the answer time. Yes, he can stay in the pocket and throw.
And a big knee from Doumbé. He wants the knockout finish here in the second round. He's got to be careful, though.
Yeah, Doumbé did throw some uppercuts.
second round.
Oh, and it's got him again. Haroop does not look all there right now.
But he's still finding a way to throw back.
Look at Dubé. Leave it alone. Big uppercut. Paul Nichols may jump in there in a second. Oh, he's turned his back. And it's another knockdown for Dubé.
It was called a knockdown.
And Dubé thought he won. He thinks the fight's over. It's not over.
Gregorian even one. Spit out his mouthpiece.
I hate to say this, Joe, but what an idiot. What is Dubé doing?
Six.
I have
seven,
no clue.
Eight. Gloves up.
He gave Haroon about 25 seconds.
And his mouth guard's out.
This is insanity. Dubé may have just wasted a title win there. And now they'll fight again. Has Haroop regained his faculties? Oh, the left hook connects.